Video shows police arresting two skateboarders who were accused of trespassing at a skate park.
It's an officer going too far with a 15-year-old skateboarder right near City Hall.
Arrested for assault.
Just give us the board.
Give me this board. Hey. Being shoved to the ground by a state trooper. Yo. State police say he was one of two people arrested on trespassing charges.
So this is actually kind of sick. I had this board, but then something happened to it. It got thrown out. I had got in like 2000 and I skated the hell out of it. And then I went on eBay like 2 years ago and I somehow found the exact board. It's World Industries, everything from the bearings to the bolts. Now it sits in my basement. I look at it whenever I feel like it.
My name's Kyle McCarlson, and I'm 27 years old. I've been skateboarding for 10 to 15 years collectively, very consistently for the last 6 years-ish. There's definitely perhaps a misconception of skateboarding from, you know, maybe what somebody that's outside of skateboarding sees. So like, you know, there's all these beautiful parks out there, but then there's also a whole underground side of it where one might argue it's a bit more sincere and definitely probably more creative because it's more raw. It's not built for you. It's not meant to be manipulated by a skateboard, and street skateboarding is kind of just like people aren't doing it really a lot of the time, me especially, not trying to make any money out of it, not trying to be the coolest person, just kind of just doing it just to do it because I think it's cool, and I feel like it's kind of boring just to skate something that someone else built for what you're meant to do. So it seems a bit rebellious, but really it's just an attempt at being creative. When you're street skating, the only thing you're worried about really is, you know, maybe a cop or a security guard or just maybe not getting hurt, but a lot of times you don't even think of that. That's why maybe it's a bit more sincere, because you're doing it for yourself and your friends and the people that know about it, and it's not motivated by money. And like I said, I mean, some people do, even in the underground, I guess, see it as a sport, competing with one another and stuff like that, but I don't know, kidding yourself. Skating has a way of teaching you about struggles that other things in life don't. Whereas, like, there's a lot of gray area stuff in life that is easy to get attached to. Whereas in skating, it's so black and white that you have to learn to, like, it just accept it or figure it out. So, I think that from that, I've realized in skating the acceptance or the just let it go on more of like an immediate level, and tried to bring that into my life. Whereas like, I'm either gonna accept it or I'm gonna do something about it. And it used to just be like, I would kind of bitch about it until I got over it. But now I'm like, well, there's no point of bitching about it. It's not gonna help you learn the trick. It's not gonna help you figure out anything in life. You just have to accept it or figure it out. There's no other, like, the gray area is kind of just devastating. And does it burn? What's been in your head? Standing there in the cold.
My name is Sean Van Pelt. I'm a skateboarder, a youth development intern here at the YMCA, and a skate park supervisor. I believe my aunt got me and my brother's skateboards. I was about 4 years old. I started watching X Games when I was about 12. And that reintroduced me into skateboarding, and that's what made me want to start trying it again. If I didn't have skateboarding in my life, I'd say I'd be like I'd be overweight, I'd be socially awkward, I wouldn't have any friends. Like, skateboarding has given me friends, it's given me like good exercise, it's given me drive, it's helped me in my professional career, you know? It's helped me in so many ways that I can't even imagine my life without it, because it's basically woven itself in every aspect of my life. Without it, I'd be nothing. It's truly different from all other sports in the aspect that you're by yourself. You're not really working with a team, you're just alone. You could be by yourself in a parking lot for hours and then that's a good session. People think we're rude, people think we're destructive. You know, we don't respect authority and that we don't have a plan for anything. When, you know, for some that is true, but I know for a majority we're some of the nicest, kindest people I know are skateboarders, you know. Some of the smartest people I know are skateboarders. It really just depends on, you know, your surroundings and what you're exposed to.
There are so many different tricks, so many different things you can skate, like a ledge, a rail, a stair set. You know, you can do flip tricks, you can do manual tricks, just a whole bunch of stuff.
So here I'm an instructor. I teach kids how to skate, and I just look at each lesson as a way to pass on the torch of skateboarding, pass on that drive, you know, because all we're really doing here is having fun, and I just want to, I want someone to land that trick, and I want them to have that feeling of stoke that I get and have that smile, because when they get that, I feel that again, and I like to feel that with them, and it's really fun, and skateboarding is really about the older guys teaching the younger guys, and I think it's a really good thing that we have that. Well, I think this place has really helped boost the image of skateboarding. Recently, I've heard a lot of parents come up to me and say how much they've loved seeing the skate park here, how they've heard great things about it, and I've heard from our director here, Danny Hans, that the skate park specifically has had its best year so far. So it's just helped us with projecting the image that we want people to see.
How would you respond to someone who says skateboarding is a crime?
I would ask them to come to the skate park here and ask these kids if they're criminals, like if what they think about that, because if you ask these kids, it's the most fun thing they've ever done, you know? They have a stressful day. This is what they look forward to. This is what I look forward to. I know people have been kind of afraid and intimidated by skateboarders a lot because they have seen us as destructive teenagers and all that. But now I think they see us more as kids who just want to have fun and skateboard. We're not a bunch of crooks.